That was close.
Yeah, just a bit. You did get both of them though, right?
Wait, there were two of them?
Connor!
Oh, there it is.
Connor!
Oh, right. This was a great idea, getting the old gang back together. Isn't that right, Birdo? See? It's gonna be great.
It will be great to have them all back.
Do you reckon Lester's forgiven us yet?
Connor, it's been 5 years. Lester, don't hold a grudge that long.
He's still not forgiven me over mucking up his apartment.
Connor, you set fire to his kitchen.
And we've got another housemate from the prehistoric era. I still don't think he likes Rex.
Where's Rex?
He's watching the oven.
Right, I'll go and find him.
This is gonna be great! Abby!
What is it? Oh.
It's another anomaly.
I thought we'd seen the last of those.
What do we do? We don't have any of the tech.
Stay calm, Connor. Maybe it won't last long?
Well, that's different.
Connor, grab it!
Well done.
Let's get it back through the anomaly before it closes.
Aren't you curious?
About what?
It had this sword on its wing. Bit odd.
Yeah, it is.
Do you want to go and investigate?
We don't have time, Connor. Everyone's going to be there in 20 minutes.
Oh, come on! We don't know how many opportunities to do this we have. This is the first anomaly in 5 years.
Fine then, but we've got to be quick.
Brilliant!
Let's go.
I never got used to the time travel.
Same. Hang on.
What is it?
Look!
That's a bloke. How can there be a bloke here?
He must have come through another anomaly. Come on.
He's just a kid.
Are you okay?
Who are you guys?
I'm Connor, and this is my wife, Abby. Who are you?
My name's Hart.
Hang on, what?
It's just a coincidence, Hart. How did you get here?
There was a golden light. I was chasing a strange bird, and it ran through. So I followed. It then ran off with my sword.
Wait, this one?
Yeah. That's mine.
Tell me, where was the light?
Well, it's that one over there.
But that's our anomaly.
Something very strange is going on.
What was that?
I don't know. Let's find out.
Are you sure that's a good idea?
We've got to get back somehow.
Right. Either this isn't our apartment, or Becca has already got very drunk. We're back!
This is Heart's time.
Does that finally mean no dinosaurs? Ah, Heart! You have returned!
Yes, Chief, and I've brought visitors.
Who are these strange people? That's rich coming from you.
Connor!
Are you aware of who you're talking to?
Nope. I am Viking Chief Temple, and this is my slave Cutter. This has some serious Blackadder vibes about it. You two are not the first strange visitors to come to us today.
Oh, really?
A woman came through a light of gold and gave me this. She called it a Christmas present.
What the flip?
Chief, I need you to describe this woman.
She had brown hair and had strange machinery in her bag.
Connor, this sounds way too much like Helen.
But Helen Cutter's dead. Danny saw her die.
Time travel, Connor. This is clearly Helen from before her death.
Blimey. Sorry, Chief Temple, but I'm going to need to take your weapon.
Get up, Cutter!
I'm sorry. I can't.
You will pay for this! Abby!
Thank you very much, Viking Chief Temple. Come on, Connor.
So what's Helen Cutter doing?
She's trying to change time again. It seems that we've got to keep following her.
But what about our party?
Connor, I think this might be a bit more important.
Corporal! What is the report from the field?
The fighting has ceased. The troops have called a truce.
Is there any explanation?
Despite the war, today is still Christmas. This is happening throughout Europe.
Let the troops have today then. It's a pity it won't continue. Tomorrow the guns will start again.
There's something else.
What is it, Corporal?
A woman arrived in our trench. She demanded to meet with someone in charge.
Send her up. Right then, madam. Who are you and what are you doing here?
I can help you change the course of the war.
Don't be ridiculous.
End the ceasefire early. Start the attack again.
Don't you have any morals? Today is Christmas Day. Let the soldiers have their day.
Tell me, Major, will the soldiers thank you if they're still fighting in 4 years when there is the chance to end it today? Consider it, Major. Think about the long-term solution.
Where are we now?
It's some sort of battleground.
What the blazes are you doing here?
You wouldn't believe us.
Who are you?
I am Corporal Becker.
This Blackadder vibe is really getting on my nerves now.
I guess you picked a lucky day, if there could be one.
Why?
Well, because of there being no fighting today, the one day we won't die. Now, if you could follow me, I think you two ought to go to the Major.
Connor. This is World War One, Christmas Day, 1914.
Major Lester?
Lester?
What is it, Becca?
I found two civilians next to the field.
How the blazes did you get here?
Long story.
Well, don't worry. We'll have you shipped back to England soon enough. But you two are going to need to stay out of the way. Becca!
Sir!
Send word to the men. The fighting will recommence within the hour.
But sir, the truce!
You will not question my orders, Becca!
Wait, stop.
What is it now?
Have you had a visit from a strange woman named Helen Cutter?
Does it matter?
Major, she is trying to ruin the course of history.
She is trying to end the war early. Will my men thank me for letting them off a day if the war carries on another 4 years?
You don't know that fighting today will help.
All you know about your choice is that it would lose so many people their Christmas. You don't know the long-term effects of bringing fighting forward, and we can't tell you if it will be better or worse, but the short-term effect is mass killing on Christmas Day.
But tactically...
Forget tactics! Show compassion!
I will consider it. You two! Against my better judgment, I will listen to you and keep the ceasefire.
Thank you.
Where are you going?
Don't worry about us.
We have a way out of here.
What are you waiting for, Major? Call the attack!
I don't think so, Miss Cutter. Why not learn some compassion?
Where did your change of heart come from?
Two people who came to us and showed us why compassion is important.
Those interfering misfits. Well, if I can't change the course of history myself, then I can force them to change their own. This time, it's something they cannot resist changing. When's Stephen arriving?
Around 4, I think.
I see.
Why are you even doing this? We never celebrate Christmas.
That seemed like a good idea.
Where are we this time?
Some sort of apartment. Hang on, that's not...
Yeah, it's Stephen.
But he looks... younger.
So this is before we all came together, before they knew about the anomalies.
Hang on, but we've got this great anomaly right here, right now.
Hang on, all this visiting our ancestors, you don't think Helen's trying to change our history? She's trying to prevent the Ark.
I mean, that does sound like something Helen would do.
We can't let Stephen see this anomaly.
Sorry, children, but my methods aren't that simple. Now Stephen beckons. Stephen?
Helen, what are you doing out here?
Needed to be away from Nick.
Don't listen to anything she says!
Don't you think we should tell Nick about our interests?
No, it was one night, Helen. It doesn't need to go out.
But what if it wasn't one night?
Stephen!
He'd definitely never find out this early.
They might still form the team.
You've completely betrayed me, Stephen. Stay away from me and my wife.
Don't think so.
plan going perfectly. This time you two can't prevent it.
How do we stop her now?
With this?
Connor, you're a genius!
That's as far as the genius goes.
Where do we go?
We need to find the professor at a point where he's not too angry.
He is known to hold a grudge.
So, a few months?
That might be enough time.
Where are we now?
Well, Stephen isn't surprised about Helen and the affair is happening, so 8 years before we all met. So that is...
1999. Christmas, 1999.
So January 2000 then?
Let's go and save our future.
Oh, Helen, where did they all go so wrong? When will I get some peace?
Don't shoot!
What are you doing here?
Professor, you need to listen to us.
It's important.
Hang on a minute. You're the kid Temple. You've aged a bit in the last year.
Hang on, what?
Professor, we're from your future. What is the exact date?
4th of March, 2007.
Ah.
Connor, this isn't 1 month later, it's 8 years later.
Sorry, it's hard operating Helen's device.
Helen?
Yeah. Your wife.
She's no wife of mine. She cheated on me with my best friend, then disappeared a week later. Never to be seen again.
What about Stephen?
Cut him out of my life forever.
So, what are you doing with your life?
I found these things called anomalies. They're portals to another time. I believe it's my job to find them, prevent any creatures coming through.
And you're doing this on your own?
I can't trust anyone else.
Professor, you need to listen to us. Helen is manipulating time. Where we come from, we've been a team hunting anomalies for 12 years.
And then what changed?
You were never meant to find out about Stephen and Helen's affair. Not yet, anyway.
How does finding out later make things any better?
Because you had friends to help you. Me, Abby, Jenny. Your world became so much bigger than Helen and Stephen. You inspire so many people all around the world. And that inspiration saved so many lives and stopped so many life-changing disasters.
At what cost?
People died. But so many more are saved.
Connor, the anomaly is closing.
We've got to go.
Wait. Just tell me. Is it worth it? All this research, searching for anomalies, is it worth it?
Yes, absolutely. You are an icon.
Connor!
We've got to go.
So then, time to find that kid Connor.
Just in time.
So, did we do it? Did we prevent Helen?
Well, we're still here.
We'll only know if the others show up.
Took long enough, Connor. We've been out here 10 minutes already.
Abby? I think everything is fine.
What do you mean everything's fine, Connor?
Don't worry about him. I don't think he goes to many Christmas events.
Why doesn't that surprise me?
Evening, Connor. Abby.
Good to see you, Becca. I'd like to thank you all for coming, and I just want to pause for a moment to remember all those that couldn't be here. Through prior engagement or through death.
Connor!
Okay, I could have phrased that better, but you'll get the idea.
I'm here.
But...
that's impossible.
Are you two okay?
What's got you two startled?
They've just been drinking too much. Never thought I'd say this. Good to see you, Professor.
Sorry I'm late.